Look, these are two separate pieces. Just few clicks and they have become one. The process you just saw is called spot welding, and this technique of welding is used in many industrial and automotive applications to weld many sheets together to form a single piece. This is also the preferred method of joining cells to make a DIY battery pack, because soldering on a lithium battery is one of the dumbest things that you can do. They get very angry when they get hot. So today I will be explaining the principle behind spot welding, and I will also take you through my design journey of how I made a DIY spot welder. So let's get started. Spot welding is basically sorting out very high current source on the surface for a brief period of time. Huge amount of current flows to the surface, which causes that metal to get super hot and fuse with one another. The principle is that simple. So making a spot welder sounds really easy, isn't it? And in fact it is. So let's see how we can build one. All we need here is a current source. So this current source can be anything. This can be your lipo battery or hacked microwave transformer or even capacitor bank. Then we want some wires to bring that current onto the surface. A switch in between, because having current at open electrodes is not particularly safe. We first want to place the electrodes on the surface, then close the circuit and let that current weld those metal pieces. But these kind of switches are not really going to work, so we need either a big automotive transformer relay or a MOSFET bank. So now here comes another problem. If you even manage to switch that high current, it is very difficult to manage the timing with a human hand. If the timing is too short, then there is not going to be a sufficiently good weld, and if the pulse is too long, this can damage the battery. Like, this can literally create a hole in your battery pack. So having precise timing from a human is a really difficult thing to achieve, so we also need to add a microcontroller here that can precisely time the switching of those switches. As we have added a microcontroller anyways, we may also want to add a foot switch input to begin the welding process. Maybe also add a potentiometer or a rotatory encoder to change the duration of the welding pulse. We may also want to see our settings, so let's also add a display here so that we can preview our settings. Add a buzzer and LED to notify whether the microcontroller is actually welding or not. With the initial planning out of the way, we can create a circuit around that. I am using EasyEDS software, which is a free online circuit and PCB designing software. Not sponsored, by the way, it is free and I use it to do all my designs. The reason that I love using this is because it is linked with LCSC, which is another component sourcing website. I can search and choose the components at LCSC, copy that LCSC part number, and then I can immediately get the footprints of them in EGDA. This also makes sourcing very, very easy when I actually need to import those components. For the microcontroller, I decided to choose Arduino Pro Mini because it has a very compact size and easy programming. I also added a 0.96 inch OLED display because it is a small and high resolution display where I can show all kind of informations. And for the input method, I opted for a rotatory encoder because it is just so satisfying to scroll this encoder. And also I can very finely control these settings. For the switch, I had three options. One, adding a MOSFET bank. Second, using automotive solenoid relay. Or third, using a small 12 volt relay to turn on and off primary side of hacked microwave oven transformer. So I said, why limit ourselves with just one option? Let's add all of them. So all three of them are present here in the circuit. And I convinced myself to add all of this because my future self will do some programming magic later on and make them all work seamlessly. Then I added some power electronics, buzzer, foot switch input, and the circuit was basically complete in no time. Now I can convert the circuit into the PCB. placing the similar components near to one another, adding connectors to the correct sides, and so on.
75 years later.
This is the final PCB layout that I came up with. We can also see the PCB in 3D from here to look at the beauty you have created. Then we can export the gravures from the software and download them onto the computer. Then we can basically head to the JLC PCB website, upload the gravures, check the color we like, and place the order. The PCB are basically for free right now if you have created the design from EGDA software. For me, living here in Nepal, the shipping cost accounts for the majority of the cost, but for the other countries, the shipping may be much more affordable. Roughly after 7 to 10 days, you will have PCB in your hand, and they always have a great quality. I never had any complaints with them. After about 20 to 30 minutes of soldering, it is almost done. The MOSFETs need the copper black plate as the current collector, which I have already installed on my completed PCB. The PCB also has heavy copper reinforcement in the bottom side of the PCB for the battery negative and positive terminals. Now comes the most difficult task of all, coding. It took me more than 15 days to write and debug the code for this, but for the video, I will make it look like I'm an expert, and it only took me a few minutes.
Run.
You can also access this code, so you don't need to go through the pain that I went through. I have added a lot of additional features like multi-pulse welding, battery low voltage protection, option to add external switching relay, and so on, which you can know by watching my previous video on this topic. Finally, to make the welding electrodes, I drilled on the brass bolts and used copper wire as the consumable electrode on one side and soldered flexible silicon wire on the other side. Then wrapped it all with a heat shrink tube. I also added a XT60 connector on the battery end, and this is basically it. So here is the final product. Let's see this in action. Thank you, my Patreon, Mr. Ben Ruiz, for supporting me on Patreon. You can also join me on Patreon and get full access to the whole documentation, bill of materials, editable code, and circuit diagram, and the PCB. The same thing will also be available in my Instructables, but it will have a compiled code. Thank you all for watching this video. See you in my next one. Bye bye.